Namaskar. We are covering the most important questions that might be asked in the upcoming UPSC PT examination 2021. Ansupa Lake and Chilka Lake is in the news because the government of Odisha has asked the central government to fund their project for the conservation of this wetland and lagoon in Odisha, and the government has approved this program. And these places are of significance for civil service aspirants. The type of questions that might be asked are, like, for example, number one, consider the following statements about Lake Ansupa in Odisha. A. It is Odisha's largest freshwater lake and surrounded by Saranda Hills. B. It is situated near the bank of river Mahanadi. C. It is suited for the nesting and hatching of olive ridley turtle. D. It is wetland and part of Gahir Matha Wildlife Sanctuary in Odisha. Which of the above statement is correct? Another type of question could be, Chilka Lake in India is A. The largest brackish water lagoon. B. It is a part of National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem. C. It is known for home of migratory birds in Nalbana Bird Sanctuary located in this area. D. Red crabs and Irrawaddy dolphins are found in Lake Chilka. Which of the above statement is not correct? The question number 3 could be, National Lake Conservation Plan (NLCP) includes which of the following lakes in India? A. Dal Nagin Lake in Srinagar. B. Pushkar and Pichola Lake in Rajasthan. C. Sivpur and Sindh Sagar Lake in MP. D. Chilka Lake and Ansupa Lake in Odisha. Which of the following are correct? A, B, C, D, all, none of the above, 2, A, C, D, and the 4, A, B, and C only. 4. How many sites are there under Ramsar Convention on Wetlands in India, and what is the main principle of the Ramsar Convention? So this kind of a question, apart from the other locations and the fact and the ideas related to this concept of the wetland, Ramsar Convention, these places, olive ridley turtle, red crabs, Irrawaddy dolphin, that can be asked in various permutation and combinations. So start with it. Let's have a look of this video about the Ansupa Lake. This lake was being dirtied by the growth of the water hyacinth in this area, and as in this video you can see that some local people are cleaning it, and these are the local Odia people who used to this lake for the fisheries, and even they were responsible and for the protection and the cleaning up program with the help of the local body. This is the contamination that has been done over the years to Ansupa Lake, and these hills are the Saranda Hills, which encloses the Lake Ansupa in Odisha. And this is a real footage of Lake Ansupa in Odisha. You can see some flying birds over there. These flying birds are the migratory birds which used to come for their feeding and breeding near the Lake of Ansupa as well as in the Lake of Chilka in Odisha, and during the winter season most probably. And these are the fishing nets by the local fishermen. And this is an overall view of the Lake Ansupa in Odisha, and this is the sunset in that lake. Hope you like this video, and isn't it? It is very beautiful sunset sight in this lake. Moving ahead, why is in the news? And we have already discussed that why it is in news, but this is in short for your recall of the fact. The state government has asked the center to approve the 5-year integrated management plan for Ansupa Lake, and this Ansupa Lake lies in the state of Odisha in India, and it is the largest freshwater, mind it, it's a freshwater lake, and the shape of this lake is of horseshoe shape. It means it is in a shape like this. Encloses. This is known as the horseshoe shaped lake water body. The Odisha Wetland Authority has approved implementation of an integrated management plan for Chilka, the country's largest brackish water lagoon. So you need to differentiate that the Chilka is a lagoon, and lagoon primarily means that it will be brackish and it is a salt water lake. But on the contrary to that, Ansupa Lake is a fresh water lake. So please keep that in mind. And the estimated investment for this project is nearly 180 crores. Although this figure is not for the remembering purpose, but might be in some permutation combination, if any question asks that way, you will be in a position to answer that question. Now, the exact geographical location, you must be aware of the Lake Chilika as well as the Lake Ansupa. Both the lakes are situated nearby, and that is why I am just showing you the location. This is precisely, here is the state of Odisha in the map of India. This is the Bay of Bengal, and this is the eastern side of the country, and here this is the precise location of the Lake Ansupa. If we enlarge this area, this entire area, into the bigger area, here you can see that this is Cuttack, and just to the west of Cuttack, this is Ansupa. This is Ansupa, and this area is a breeding ground for the olive red-legged turtle. So this information is interrelated with this location. And here is the Gahir Matha Marine Wildlife Sanctuary, which is the largest breeding and hatching ground for the olive red-legged turtle. Olive red-legged turtle. We have covered a different detailed section for the olive red-legged turtle in our video, and if you wish to know about them, you can have a watch. And this is Lake Chilika. So this is precise location for the Chilika Lake. This is, here is the Ansupa Lake. Hope these locations are now clear to you. Moving ahead, there are some other factual information that as an aspirant of the UPSC, you should know that this is River Mahanadi. This is River Mahanadi, and Cuttack is situated on the bank of River Mahanadi. Along the bank of the River Mahanadi, this is the Ansupa Lake. So Ansupa Lake is basically a kind of a wetland. It is a wetland, and it is formed by the Mahanadi. So these are the subtributaries of and distributaries of Mahanadi, which will ultimately fall into the Bay of Bengal. So it is a type of a wetland created by Mahanadi, and the total area covered is 141 hectares. The fresh water lake situated amidst the Saranda Hills. So Saranda Hills is the another location that can be asked, and you must be aware that it is related with the Ansupa Lake, and enclosed by the bamboo tree greenery and the mango tree. Bamboo trees are a tree which is usually occurs in an area of high rainfall. So if there is a presence of bamboo tree, it means that the rainfall is high. Since it is situated on the bank of the Bay of Bengal, so it receives a good amount of a monsoon. India's largest freshwater lake, it is the Odisha's largest freshwater lake, and it is silted up. The major problem is it is silted up by a drastic reduction of water inflow from the Mahanadi. So this is how it has been created over the time, being redeveloped by the intervention of the state government. This is Chilika Lake, and Chilika Development Authority is associated with the development of the Chilika Lake as well as the some of the development works for the Lake Ansupa. And here in this India's map, this is precisely the location of the Chilika Lake. This is Chilika Lake. And there are some other rivers like the river Daya River, Bhargavi River, and the Khushbhadra River, and then this Devi estuaries and the Devi River. Devi River is also a place where the olive red-legged turtles used to come for their breeding and hatching. So these all location can be asked in various way in UPSC examination, and these are all the distributaries and the tributaries of Mahanadi situated in Odisha. So you must be aware of these various location. Land acquisition is already in process for this development project, and there is a proposal for the development of eco-tourism projects worth of nearly 40 crores rupees. And Chilika, the saltwater lagoon, in Odisha has a development authority which is known as the CDA, the nodal agency, and under the guidance of the CDA, the National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem. Remember, National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem will be implemented in the Chilika Lake region. This is important because there are various plans for the conservation of water bodies in India. So you must remember that Chilika falls under the National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem. There are some important things related with it, and start with that, it provides further encouragement for the conservation and protection of wetland as well as for the other water bodies across the country. It is home to the migratory birds, the picturesque hamlet of Ansupa and the lagoons of Chilika are a paradise for the nature conserves with the immense protection of ecological tourism. So this could be the economic gain for the local people and the fisher community in those areas. Moving forward, it provides a food. This is a pohala fish. That is the local name of Labiobata. Labiobata is a very popular fish being fried in Odisha as well as in the area of Bengal. This is found over here. Safeguard against the natural calamities like tsunami. These area, these wetlands, and somehow they do produce a kind of a mangrove vegetation in the coastal region. These are a kind of a protection from the tsunami waves in Odisha. If we plant this along the shores, we can have mitigated the impact of tsunami in those coastal area. It is a conservation of ecology. An integrated management plan by state government has launched promotion of sustainable livelihood for the fishermen. So this is another important of this. It is a wintering ground for nearly 32 species of migratory bird, and there is a national bird sanctuary, Nalbana, N-A-L-B-A-N-A, Nalbana Bird Sanctuary. It is situated nearby Chilika Lake. Even flamingo used to come to these areas, and people in the winter visited Chilika Lake and the Nalbana Bird Sanctuary to witness the picturesque view of these migratory birds. Famous for its sweet water fish, this is in sweet water fish, pohla, specially Labato Bata. So these are the another impact, and in this way it provides the food security for the local person in that lake area. Moving towards the another important thing is sustaining from the freshwater supply during the rainy season from the Mahanadi. So because the rain is high during the monsoon season, so now you can see in this image there are some patches which are going to be dry in this area. These areas are going dry because of the non-supply of water in the non-rainy season. With reduced inflow over the years, the lake's hydrology has undergone serious and visible changes. The water spreads area has reduced and fishery resources is almost non-existent nearby Ansupa now. So Ansupa Lake has now the falling number of fishes. The 5-year management of lake is intended at strengthening livelihood of thousands of fishermen relying on these two water body, that is of Ansupa and Chilika. The other important fact about this place is that these are Irrawaddy dolphins. These Irrawaddy dolphins, look at that, how cute it is. Isn't it look like it is smiling at us? So these Irrawaddy dolphins are believed to be migrated from Irrawaddy river to this area. So apart from tourism promotion, it is also the conservation strategy for the ecology of this area. Chilika is spread over an 1100 square kilometer, and lakh of tourists visit the lake to watch endangered, mind it, in the IUCN list. The Irrawaddy dolphins are under endangered category and migratory birds during winter. In this map of India, if you can see that here, this kind of structure, this inland structure is the precise location for Chilika. So this may help you to locate the Chilika Lake here. Apart from the Chilika Lake, across the shore of the Bay of Bengal in the eastern side, there is one another lagoon, which is Pulikat Lagoon, is also asked by UPSC various times. So in this image, you must be remembering that the Chilika Lake, Pulikat Lake, these all lakes are on the eastern coast, on the eastern coast of the Indian Peninsula, and Chilika is situated nearby the Mahanadi. So these all locations becomes important for you for the upcoming examination and even preparation for other examinations as well. There is a brief definition of what exactly is a wetland and what exactly is a lake. So wetlands, and this definition has been given by the National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem. So they define wetland as shallow water bodies less than 2 meter depth. Water recedes in dry season, supports dominant macrophyte growth, and aquatic biodiversity is known as wetlands. In contrary to wetlands, lakes are relatively deep and permanent water bodies. They have limited submerged microphytes, and they have fishes provide water for varying human consumption as well. So these human consumption, there is no direct human consumption. So these are the difference and the definitions given by the National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem on wetlands and lakes. There are some specific uses being delineated by the NPCAE, and these are like life support system for in under that category, drinking water supply for agriculture and fisheries, habitat for the flora and fauna, habitat for migratory birds, recharging of aquifers and groundwater, recreational purposes and educational and scientific research value, biodiversity, flood control, sediment load reduction, and water waste treatment pollution sinks. They somehow helps in reducing the CO2 level into the atmosphere. Wetlands and lakes are basically the lifeline of the society, and in this bulleted point you can pin out that what are these importance. Number one is water and food security. Number two, regulates water designs, buffer extreme events as flood and storm and tsunami, supports livelihood, recreational purposes in terms of ecotourism. Then the cultural identity, it builds a cultural identity for the local people. So maybe suppose that there is question in the examination that followings are the importance of the wetlands and lakes in India, and maybe they can write that it is a part of Indian cultural identity. If you don't know exactly that it has been delineated under the Ramsar Convention as well, you may think that how a wetland can be a cultural identity. So in that manner, this kind of the conceptual answers you must be knowing and understanding, and the depth understanding of that can help you in relate this information along with the concepts. What are the major threats for these wetlands and lakes in India and in general, and for particularly Ansupa and Chilika are? Number one is fragmentation of hydrological regime due to construction or maybe due to the drying of this area. Number second is catchment degradation, and this catchment degradation can be done by constructing road, buildings, hotels in the catchment basin of the nearby rivers. Third could be conversion for alternate uses of the land, and then deviation of the rivers from those area. Pollution can be the added problem. Over harvest of resources can be the another threat to these areas. And invasive species, it means introducing something non-local to those areas, especially kind of a tree or animal, which are non-very coexistent with the other biodiversity of and flora and fauna of the area, can be a major threat to this kind of a ecosystem and in general for the wetlands. there are some other national efforts for saving of the water body. One of them is, number one is National Lake Conservation Plan, which is known as NLCP, and major ongoing lakes names that may be asked in the examination could be Dal Nagin Lake, and you need to remember that this lake is situated in Srinagar, Pichola, Fateh Sagar and Pushkar Lake, these are in Rajasthan, Shivpuri and Sindh Sagar Lake in MP, Ramgarh Tal and the Lakshmi Tal in UP, and Mokakakuchung in Nagaland. These are the names of the lake which has been chosen by the National Lake Conservation Plan. So you need to precisely know the information and you have to have the knowledge about their locations. Second authority is National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem, and Chilika falls under this project. And the third is the National Wetland Conservation Program, which is known as NWCP. ANSUPA falls under this. So there is one differentiation that the ANSUPA and Chilika are not under National Lake Conservation Plan. They are under National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem and National Wetland Conservation Program. Internationally, the Ramsar sites, the Ramsar Convention on Wetlands, is committed to wise use principle. Wise use principle means it is not that you should not use the wetlands and the lake for the human benefits. You must use it, but in order to protect them, not to over drain them. And they have delineated total 46 wetlands designated as Ramsar site in India. ANSUPA and Chilika both come under this. So this is another added fact that you should remember. And the other interesting fact is that the Ramsar Conservation awards the Chilika Development Authority for ecological interventions in Chilika Lake, followed by the World Wetland Day, which is celebrated every year on 2nd of February. So this is a fact that the World Wetland Day is on 2nd February to mark the signing of the Ramsar Convention. And in 2016, in the West Bengal, Sundarban was selected as the WWD celebration site. And in this map, there are other Ramsar sites in India, which is a very popular locations for UPSC to ask in a various permutation combination in examination, like the Rudra Sagar. This is situated in Tripura and UPSC ask about it. Loktak Lake in Manipur is a freshwater lake, and it is also a Ramsar site in India, and UPSC keep ask the questions about those lakes. So in detail you must read before this locations and going into the examination. The Sambar Lake and the Keoladev National Park are in Rajasthan. These are also, the Sambar and the Keoladev has been asked repeatedly in various examination. Wooler Lake in Jammu and Kashmir, Pongdang Lake, Kanjili, Harike Lake, Roper. So these all location, Kalinji, Harike and Roper are in Punjab. So these lakes are the Ramsar sites in India, and you one must go through it. For example, like in Kerala, there are three lakes: Vembadan Coal Wetland, Sastama Kota Lake and the Astama Mudi Wetland. So these three are becoming very important, and in Kerala, UPSC used to ask this name and a question that where they are situated, all the rivers along with them are important. Even Kolleru Lake is also important, Chilika is also a site, and then the Bhitarkanika mangroves, this also in Odisha. So maybe the questions can be, Chilika is a Ramsar site, and there parallelly Bhitarkanika is a mangrove forest, and it is also situated in Odisha. Which of the statements are correct? So you must be very clear while answering and attempting these questions in UPSC examination. Moving towards the next, this is an integrated image along with the name of the sites under the Ramsar, like the Astamudi wetland in Kerala, Bias Conservation Reserve, Punjab, Bhitarkanika Mangroves, Odisha, Bhoj wetland, Madhya Pradesh, Chandratal wetland, Himachal Pradesh, Chilika in Odisha, Diporville, Assam, East Calcutta wetland in West Bengal, Harike in Punjab, Hokar wetland, Jammu and Kashmir, then Kalinji Lake, Punjab, Kevladev Ghana National Park, Rajasthan. So these all names and the list are important. So once you go on the website of the Environmental Resource Ramsar Wetland Sites in India, and you can see all those locations. So Ramsar is going to be important for the UPSC examination. Please read all the class related to it. Now moving towards the other part. Hopefully now almost you get all the answers that has been asked at the beginning, but just for your queries, I am answering those. Like, consider the following statements about Lake Ansupa in Odisha. It is Odisha's largest lake, freshwater lake, and surrounded by Saranda Hills. This statement is true. It is situated near the bank of river Mahanadi. Of course, it is true. It is situated for the nesting and hatching of olive ridley turtle. Now you know that this is not correct. It is a wetland and part of Gahir Matha Wildlife Sanctuary. Remember, Gahir Matha is a marine sanctuary. And this is a wetland created by the Mahanadi. So this statement is false. So only A and B are correct. Chilika Lake in India is the largest brackish water lagoon. True. It is a part of National Plan for Conservation of Aquatic Ecosystem. True. It is known for home of migratory birds in Nalwala Bird Sanctuary located in this area. Very true. D. Red crabs and Irrawaddy dolphins are found in Lake Chilika. Irrawaddy dolphins are found and even red crabs are found in Chilika. So these all statements are correct. National Lake Conservation Plan includes which following sites of India? Dal Nagin Lake, yes, in Srinagar. Pushkar and Pichola Lake, yes. Shivpuri and Sindh Sagar Lake, that is in MPS. Chilika Lake and Ansupa Lake, no. Because these Chilika is under the National Plan for the Development of Aquatic Ecosystem and Ansupa is the wetland conservation. So this is the wrong answer. Which one of the following are correct? So now you can delineate out of it. How many sites are under Ramsar Convention on Wetland in India? And the answer is 46 at present as per the recent report of 2021. There are some other questions that you can attempt for your understanding and then maybe for the mains purpose as well. Can you write the importance of wetland for conservation of biodiversity? What should be the approach of local government bodies to preserve wetlands in their area? Wetlands are kidney of ecosystem. If we are not sensitive toward this, how ethical it is to blame the government? Elaborate your views on it. So these all locations are not just important for your PT purpose. You can use these examples and the lesson learned out of these areas implementation for the production in writing the various GS paper for your mains examination. If you like it, if you wanted to discuss about all those questions, please answer in the comment session. Thank you. We will be taking up another current topic soon in our next video. See you there. Subscribe the Ensemble Ias YouTube channel for your civil service preparations. Thank you. Namaste.
To have more such discussions and analysis, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for notifications on our upcoming videos.